What's going on, guys? CWG here. Welcome to episode 80 of the Vault Hunters SMP. Did you know 80 sounds like 8T? Interesting. That is truly enlightening. Thank you. What's going on, guys? We're at episode 80. I mean, how insane is that? We're only 20 away from 100 already. That's bananas. What do you think, Periscope Face? Is that bananas?
Yes, Hibs. Yes, it is.
Thank you. So, as you can see, I ran some vaults in between episodes. We're level 71 and a half. I have all these crates to open that we're going to open like right now. I'm not even going to show you guys what I did in between episodes yet. Oh, a wealthy Catalyze with no negatives? Gonna buy that for show. Actually, before I open these crates, there is one thing I want to do. Last episode, we made these HDPE sheets in which they can be used to make the HDPE reinforced elytra. And I got a comment from someone who wants us to try it out. So I say, why not? Let's make a couple reinforced alloys. Look, we're back to over 200 vault diamonds. You love to see it. Infuse some of this guy with the echo ore. Nice. And we should be able to upgrade our elytra. HDPE reinforced elytra. Interesting. Can I enchant it using the vault enchanter? Oh, I can actually. I was not expecting that. All right, well, let's enchant away. So this reinforced elytra, I believe it gives us protection. Let's see. We have 59 protection right now. Put it on. Well, that didn't help at all. I mean, it looks kind of cool. That's for sure. Maybe it has more durability. I don't actually know what the difference is. One of y'all will have to let me know in the comments, but it looks cool. As long as I can color it yellow again, I'll be happy. Nice. All right, it's time to open some crates. Can we get an artifact? We have not gotten an artifact in like 5 episodes. Unacceptable. Well, we didn't get any artifacts, but what we did get, black chromatic steel. We had so many of the black chromatic steel quests. It's so good. We also got 6 echo gems. Nice. And a bit of lemon. A couple Catalyze here. Ooh, we're starting to get a bunch of living Catalyze again. Maybe we should try to do another living vault of doom. That sounds fun. I'm gonna go through all these jewels, roll the gear, and we'll be right back. And after rolling all that gear, I got a pretty decent helmet. It doesn't have any health though, but it does have damage and increased mana. We'll make a good backup. I mean, let's be honest here. It's gonna be really hard to beat our legendary helmet. That's faux show. You guys want a reactor update? I'll give you a reactor update. I have been working up the power in this thing, and I now have the reactor up to 60% power, which is kind of nuts. So let's go ahead and turn this reactor on. And look at it go, 60% power. Now both boilers are active now. That's how much power this thing is making. Apparently the electric boiler temperature is 7,400 degrees. I feel like that would melt pretty much any metal. But we're not going to talk about that. The question is, how much power are we making? Let's look at our turbines. They are both making 1 million FE per tick each. Yeah. So if we go to our battery here, yeah, you can see 2.06 million FE per tick. That's absolutely bananas. And in order to get our battery to the point where it can accept this much power, I've had to make a lot of upgrades. As you can see, we're now using the advanced induction providers, and those things are flipping expensive. Look, you need all these control circuits, you need 4 of these guys, which means you need 4 of these guys. Each of these is a chromatic steel and a butt ton of Larimar. I actually ran out of Larimar yesterday. I can't believe I'm saying this. I thought we would never run out of Larimar. We had like thousands of Larimar, and I used all of it just to upgrade the battery. Like, this thing is insanely expensive, but it can also hold an insane amount of power, and we need it if we're gonna run this reactor at full blast. Now you'd be maybe like, CBG, why don't you just run it at 150? Well, first of all, you saw that our turbines are pretty much completely saturated. As you can see, the turbines are running at like 90% power. So we're gonna need a bigger turbine, and I have never actually built a turbine bigger than this size. Every time I've ever used mechanism, it's been this size turbine. But I have everything inside the shulker to make the next size. Yeah, I'm pretty excited to do that. But there's another reason I can't turn up the power in this reactor. You see these ultimate pressurized tubes that are transferring the sodium in and out of the boiler? Those have a limit of like 1 million millibuckets per tick. And if I try to turn it to 93, you will see here that sodium starts going down. It's not able to transfer the hot sodium fast enough. And as you can imagine, if this sodium gets too low inside the reactor, the temperature will start increasing and going out of control. Oh, there it is. The temperature's going up. The reactor's gonna start getting damaged. Will our automatic protection, will it kick in and save the reactor from a meltdown? Look at that temperature going up. This is actually kind of terrifying. Oh, there it goes. Enter off the watch. Reactor scram. Very well, reactor operator. Report reason. High temperature warning light lit. There was a high temperature in the reactor. Very well, reactor operator. Reset protection. Reset protection I. Can you guys tell I'm having too much fun? So what I'm going to do here is add some more pipes for the reactor, and I'm going to make the turbines bigger. If you can hear a dog barking in the background, I'm sorry. I've been waiting for like 5 minutes for the dog to stop barking. He's still barking. I'm not waiting any longer for you dogs to stop barking. You hear me? Yeah, bark away. I've recorded my video. You can't stop me. I'm slowly losing my mind. We're only 5 minutes in the episode. Ah! All right, I'm going to do that thing that I said I'm going to do. We'll be right back. And we're back, and I did the stuffs and things. Take a look. I actually had to triple up the pipes on this side. Yeah, I need 3 ultimate upgraded pipes just to keep up with the amount of sodium that this reactor is heating up. On this side, it's just doubled up, and I found out this is the ideal amount. And if we go into the engine room here, check this out. These turbines are way bigger now. Look at the size of this thing. They go all the way up to the ceiling and halfway into the submarine itself. I mean, look at how many turbine blades are in this. This is so cool. And what's crazy to me is you could actually make these turbines even bigger, but that would just be like insanely expensive, and these should be enough. They can produce up to 6 million FE per tick each. Oh baby. So if we go ahead and turn on our reactor at a burn rate of 93, this was the rate that before we were running out of sodium. Activate, look, it's stable now. All of it's stable. Our boilers are boiling like they should. You love to see it. Let's go check out our giga turbines. I mean, look at the size of these things. They're huge. And they're both making 1.59 million FE each. Are you kidding me? If we take a look at our battery here, we are almost completely maxed out on the battery. That means if I want to make more power, I'm gonna have to upgrade the battery even further. That's gonna be so expensive. But just look at the insanity of this power. This is like 10 times more power than the fusion reactor makes at Mecreate Island. This thing is just bananas now. And just to remind you, it's still only running at 60% power. So the next step is gonna be to upgrade our induction matrix providers, meaning we have to make one of these guys. Insanely expensive. I'm gonna see if I even have enough materials to make this. If not, we're gonna have to like get into the vault something fierce, guys. Guys, I think we might actually have enough to upgrade this thing, surprisingly, but I have used like all of our Larimar. Let's look up how much we have left. We only have 135 Larimar. That's like nothing. We're gonna have to like run some plentiful vaults or something. Now, if we grab our 4 induction providers here that were giving us 3 million FE per tick total limit, we could combine them with a battery and some elite control circuits to make the elite induction provider, which can receive 6 million FE per tick. Pretty good. There's actually a tier above this, but that would cost so many resources, there's no way we would be able to afford it. So let's slap this guy in here, and if we reformate it, check the limit here. Yep, 6.5 million. Now let's run our reactor at even more power. Let's see how high we can get it. Can we run it at 100 millibuckets per tick burn rate? This is basically 66% power. It appears stable. Now we're making 3.2 million. Okay, I'm gonna keep working our reactor up and see how high we can get it. I found the limit pretty quickly. Look what happens. Oh no, sodium running out. That means I'm gonna need even more of these pipes, yo. This is insanity. All right, guys, we have reached our new limit. If we hit activate here, we're stable. We're running at 120 burn rate, which is 80% power. Yes. So how much power are we making with 80% of our reactor power? 4 million FE per tick. That is just insanity. And if we want to get this up any higher, I'm going to have to add even more of these freaking sodium pipes, yo. I wish there was a way to upgrade these pipes even further, but these are maxed here. So yeah, pretty cool. All right, enough reactoring. It's vaulting time. Let's slap in a vault crystal. Since we've been getting a lot of living cataly, I say we do another mushroom room extravaganza. Let's see, that one's got 6.7% instability. Okay, let's make another one, and this one's 2.7% instability. Not bad. How's our crystal doing? Oh, we're missing leaves. Yeah, leaves are still a problem, sadly. We're gonna have to wait until we unlock Britannia before we can start farming leaves. Maybe one of the people like Rob or Styrkat who have unlocked Britannia can make a leaf shop. Because everyone needs leaves, you know? Crystal complete. Make ourselves an architect seal here. Luckily, we have more vault diamonds, so it shouldn't be an issue. Slap it on the crystal. And I'm gonna put on all our low instability inscriptions. Because I want to get this living as alive as possible. Does that not make sense? Who cares? Now let's add our mushroom rooms on here and we should be ready to go. Sweet, only 12% instability. And now it's time to squeeze on as many cataly as the game will allow us to. Hopefully it doesn't exhaust on us. Oh my goodness, we're actually getting pretty lucky with this. We already have 9 livings on here. Let's keep adding more. Oh, of course. Why, right when I say we're getting lucky, it stops. But it's fine. We got 10 livings, 250% living chests. That is like really good. Luckily, we've been getting a good amount of motes through completion crates and through the bounty table. Let's throw out a mote of clarity to see what the curses are. We get hunger and slowness. I mean, it's not like the worst things ever. Slowness is a bit annoying though. Let's see if we can get rid of a slowness. Nah, I got rid of a hunger. Let's see if we can get rid of a slowness. Hey, there we go. I'll take one hunger. I'll save my motes. And you know what? I'm gonna bring our lucky goose trinket. It has one charge left. Might as well use it. Wow, look at this bounty. Submit vault apples and get, that's like 30 vault diamonds. Yo, the bounty table is seriously one of my favorite additions this season. Also, did you guys hear? Update 11 is around the corner. They're already talking about it. In fact, they already have plans for update 12 from what I heard. So there's still more cool updates that are coming to this game, and I can't wait to mess around with them when they come out. Oh, we got another item submission bounty, although I used our last bounty pearl. I'm always going through our bounty pearls. It's a bit insane. I mean, we're at the point now where we have more vault diamonds than normal diamonds. That's good. So last time we did a crazy living vault like this, we ended up getting 783 knowledge essence, I remember. Do you guys think we can break that record? Only one way to find out. Let's go. What do we get for negative modifiers? We get, wait, we didn't get any wilds. Yes, it's a Christmas miracle. And we get healing effectiveness. Nice. We did get one shortened, rapid, and literally nothing else matters. Not even the trap matters because we have 100% trap disarm. Nice. That means we don't even have to worry about finding any mobs. We just get to mine living chests. Oh, baby. Omega! Right off the bat, that's a great way to start. How much knowledge do you think we're gonna get? If this was a live stream, I would tell you to put it in the chat, but I guess you guys are gonna have to put it in the comments, and I'm gonna have to trust that you guys won't cheat. I don't know if we'll be able to beat our previous record, because we're not using our Tenos pouch like we had last time, but hopefully we still get a lot. Let's go into the giant mushroom. Everyone wants to see inside the giant mushroom, I know. The answer is a ton of living chests. Is our magnet not on? Sometimes when there's so many items, the magnet struggles. Good problem to have, I guess. Also, since we have all this extra item rarity, we're going to be getting a ton of these inscriptions. Which, I mean, it's a good thing. Omega! Because that means we can make even more of these vaults. Omega! 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 Oh my gosh, just look at all the living chests down there. This is insanity! In a good way, of course. Omega! 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 I did it, guys! I got all the living chests. You proud of me? 11,000 XP! And we get our reputation point. Look at our reputation. How much knowledge did we get? Da 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 da! 566! Alright. Doesn't beat our personal best, but that's still a lot of knowledge, obviously. And we got a ton of inscription pieces. Look, we got all these inscriptions and these inscriptions. Nice. Dang, so that means we have enough knowledge to make 22 knowledge stars, and we already have 2 knowledge stars. All right, we need to start spending some knowledge. Let's consume these 2 stars first of all, because there's a couple mods we should unlock. Elevators, boom. We finally researched it. Now I could put elevators in here to get like up, down, so I stop having to use the ladder like a peasant. Also, let's unlock trash cans. I mean, we do have our 1 trash can, and we get the trash can transmogs. Nice, but it only costs 1 knowledge star, so might as well unlock it. Now, what mod should we unlock next? And you know what I want to unlock that you probably already know because you saw the title of this video? I think we should do brews. get another tier to our potion. This one gives us 4 hearts and a bunch of cool stuffs and things. The next tier is going to give us 5 hearts healing and 3 suffix slots. Oh, baby. So that means we're going to need 12 knowledge cores, and we should have the vault diamonds for it. Yep. And boom. Consume. And unlock. Brews, dude. So, how much does a brew cost? It costs an Echo Pog, yeah, and 2 Vault Diamond blocks. I hope we have enough Vault Diamonds. Yes, we can make 2 Vault Diamond blocks. The Echo Pog's gonna be expensive, but we have all the Pogs and the Echo, so that's good. Boop. So let's make our very first brew. Recharges every 5 minutes. Oh yeah. And we get to add 3 abilities to this guy. That's exciting. So let us use our alchemy table here. We haven't used this guy in a while. Now we have been unlocking some of these things from the dungeon. Sadly, we've not been able to find the mana regen ones. Being able to get 100% mana regen would be so nice. Oh, and we need to find the item quantity ones too. Ah! So I was thinking, now that we have like our Nova build, all that jazz, I like never use our mixture because we don't need the extra mana regen. So what if instead we went for like an item quantity rarity thing? Like say there's like a bunch of chests in a POI or something. I would sip on this potion first to get some extra rarity and quantity and then break the chest. Would that be a smart C-dubs moment? I say let's go for it. Why not? I'm going to keep adding this and then removing it until I get that 8% item quantity that I want. Bruh, I went through a whole stack of mushrooms and I could not get 8%. Why does it not want to give me 8%? You know what? Instead of going item quantity first, I'm going to go mana regen first, because that's definitely going to be the third thing that I pick, because mana regen's just too useful. So I'm going to try to get to as close to 50% as I can. 36%? Not good enough. 48%! Okay, that's pretty good. Let's add our item quantity. 6%? Okay. And item rarity is another 6%. Okay, cool. So this brew has 2 uses. One, you can drink it before you mine a chest to get some extra quantity rarity. And if you need mana regen in a pinch, boom, there you go. As I mentioned earlier in this episode, we're completely out of bounty pearls, and I want more. So what if we ran a vault and just slapped on all of our wooden modifiers on it? Maybe we can get some vault pearls? Ooh, there's a waning focus inside the soul shard shop. I want one of those, and we can buy it in an hour. Alright, we just need 2,000 soul shards in this vault. How hard could that be? Our vaulter auto-completed. Very good. Now let us see if we can add all the woods. And here's the last wooden catalyst. We only got 1 curse. Okay, that's not bad. Curse. Revealio. We have explosive. Yeah, never do explosive. That's way too dangerous. Alright, sweet. Let's hop in the vault and hopefully get a lot of wooden chests. Alright, we got chunky, furious, rapid mobs, 2 shortened, and a draining. And hey, no wild modifiers at least. We've been getting quite lucky not running into any wild modifiers. And we got Hunt the Guardians, in which there's only 3 obelai. It's taking a little bit to load in. Hello, there we go. But one of those obelai is 10 guardians. That's scary, but luckily, we have our brew. Also, there's a thingy down here. Can we get a favor? Let us see. Yeah, we got a favor. Let's go. I want all the favors. That's the only thing I care about anymore. It's just how many favors can I get? We got the fish face boys. You know, it's funny. The drowned mobs actually don't really work in the water. It's ironic that the mobs that are supposed to be good in water don't know what to do. Oh, yeah. Look at these wooden POIs. This is exactly what we're looking for. We better get some extreme amounts of bounty pearls. That's the only thing I need. It's all that matters. Omega. Ooh, we got a bounty pearl. Bomb ignite door. No way. I made this key literally yesterday. This is some CWG luck. Let's get in this treasure room. Oh, I hope we get another legendary bounty. We haven't gotten one of those in so long. Ooh, artifact fragment. Ooh, a sour orange. I think this is our first sour orange of the season. That adds a full minute to the vault timer. That's definitely going in the backpack. Ooh, and we get another opportunistic focus. All right, this one's got some pretty pog stuff, I would say. We even got bonus living and bonus ornate catalyst. Nice. And what do we get in our pog gem sand? Or I guess it's called treasure sand, pog gem sand. This is where we can possibly get a legendary bounty. Come on, man. And do we get the legendary bounty? It looks like we do not. We didn't even get any echo. What the heck? You can also get like treasure keys from it. And yes, I do realize now that I was not putting items in my shulker. I was putting it back in the treasure chest. Imagine if I just left that in here. That would be bad. All right. Well, wasn't expecting it to get a treasure room in this vault, but there we go. In the first room, too. Oh, let's try out our brew. So if we drink it, it should give us some item quantity for a bit, and it pretty much gives all of our health back. Did we get a pearl from that? No, we did not get a bounty pearl. Come on, where's my bounty pearls? I just noticed that the potion effect is called steroids. That's hilarious. Hey, we got a bounty pearl. It worked. You'll love to see it. Obelai number one. Let's drink some of our brew beforehand to get our mana regen up, or I guess it's called steroids. Shoot him with a good old Nova, and then we just chop him up. Oh, there's a lot of just melee dudes. I don't like the melee dudes. They do damage, and I'm stuck. Whatever. Just keep face tanking it. We're fine. We're fine. We got plenty of mana now. And if our health ever gets too low, we can always get a little bit more of the potion. Where'd you guys come from? Go away. Also, how the heck do I get to that guardian? You're like in the wall, bro. Oh yeah, he was literally in the wall. Adorable. One obelai down. All right, it's time for the next obelai. I'm scared. There's going to be 10 of them. Oh, all right. Let's just rush down crossbow guys as quick as we can. Here's another one. Hi. Bye. And we're just going to play Ring Around the Rosie and catch up to the crossbow guys. Because the other ones will not catch up. If that made no sense, C-dubs. Sometimes you should just stop talking. I mean, whew, we are taking some damage here. Jeez. Oh no, we fell into the lower levels. Drink the potion. All right, one guy left. Oh, got him. Nice. X mark room. Are we going to get lucky? Oh boy, spiders. That's kind of scary. Well, I mean, we can use the Nova to get rid of all the small spiders. Yep. And chop up this big boy. Oh, you think you're going to come at me? You're nothing but a fat pancake because your hitbox is like a pancake. Okay. Oh, spiders, you just wait till my Nova's recharged. You're going to feel it. Here we go. Boop. All right, let's go check out the X mark. It's the bad one. Run. Get out as fast as you can! Woo! Oh, the last obelai is here. Well, we still got 12 minutes. I still want to loot, so let's block off those mobs. Ha! Nice try, pillager. You thought you were fast. Well, you ain't faster than my amazing block placing skills. Now, are you? Well, I don't want to complete the vault just yet because we got more wooden chests to loot. I mean, look at these things. Let's take a sip from our brew here so that way we can maybe get some bounty pearls. No bounty pearls? Okay, sad C-dubs noises. Where did you come from? Oh, you must have came from the other room, because spiders can climb walls. Science. Omega. Omega. There's just a few drowns here. Let's see if I can get them all with one big Nova. All right, drowns, gather round, gather round. Ready? Boom. 98 soul shards. You love to see it. Omega. Omega. All right, with 3 minutes left, let us take on these guardians. There's only 6 of them. Shouldn't be too hard. In fact, let's try to batch them up and then hit them with the Nova. There we go. That should make the crossbow boys one-hit kills. Easy peasy. And then, yeah, we just chop a Louie. Got him. Oh, there's another obelai. Can I click another one? What will happen? Oh, you cannot. Okay. I've never been able to do that before. 25,000 XP. Let's go. And how many bounty pearls did we get? That's the most important part. We got 2. Really? All that work just for 2 bounty pearls? I think we may need some more item rarity. Interesting. But hey, at least we can buy the waiting foci. And we get to dump in all of those peg gems that we got from the treasure room. I just got a magnet with a legendary 73% soul chance. That's pretty spicy. Gonna keep that around in case we do some sort of like soul shard farming build. And you know, with that artifact fragment that we got, that brings us up to 4. Do these guys still stack to 3? Oh, they stack to 4 now. Last season, these guys only stacked to 3, and it was kind of like a troll. So I guess now they can stack past 3 and we get an artifact. Is it going to be new? Let's go find out. And what artifact do we get? We got the one with 3 chests and that's another unique one. Nice. We're up to 9 artifacts now. You love to see it. We also get a couple relic fragments. Let's see if there are any of the ones that we need. Nope. Our opportunistic focus, which can only be gotten from treasure room loot. Let's put it up in this slot. We've done it. We filled all the slots. Let's just put a random one into this guy so we can fill them all. Yes, all the slots are full. Oh yeah, we have a boss crate we get to open. Kind of forgot about that. A bunch of jewels and gear. Well, let's roll all the gear that we got. See if any of that's good. Oh, we got the goat chest plate. Nice. I'll see if I can get anything good on it. Ooh, we get 7 health and 8 armor. Maybe we should use our waning focus on this, the one that we just bought. Oh, that's not that good, is it? And I lost the armor. Dang it, it was all a waste. And couldn't get anything good. Big sad. And with that, it's meme of the day time. Today's meme comes from God's Right Hand from the Discord. When the solar neutron activator that uses the sun to work in an enclosed space of the submarine has no sun access. Wait a minute. It's fine. And with that, thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure you're subscribed. I'll catch you guys next one. CWG out.